So, how will you all students today take out your social studies workbook of class 1 and look at page 30 of it? So, students, the topic which we are going to study is good manners. Like, why is it important for a children to learn good manners? Why good manners is important, and how manners can change a person, change a child from others, and how good manners can change can bring a change in his personality, and what the role a good manner can play in a child's life, and why students and teachers emphasize that a child should be learned good manners, child should be well disciplined. All these things come in good manners, because good manners are very important. It's not only good for a children, but his personality will be groomed, and he will consider a very good student, a good person in future as well, not from his childhood but in future as well. This will groom his personality, this will develop him in a civilized person when he will become become young. So that's why students and teachers, their parents and teachers emphasize on learning good manners. Now let's read. Everybody loves a child with good manners. Like I've told you earlier, like everybody praises that child which is a good manner person with good manners, because good manners is something which makes him different from other children. I'm telling, honestly speaking, if you are a good manner person, you will become you will be here. There's no, like, if you are weak in study, still you will be praised because you are a good manner person. We must talk nicely and use courteous words. We must talk nicely and use courteous words. Courteous means basically polite or respectful manner, because not only good manner, like we should learn good manner, this is not enough. We should talk nicely. The way a child will talk, that will show that how good manner he is. So they are also saying that a person should talk nicely and use such words which are polite and which comes in respectful manner. Are you getting me? Now let's see what first picture is telling us. A child is greeting a man. Like what he is saying, assalamu alaikum. He is greeting that person. You must, like, and then they are advising us that you must greet people. Like when a child is small, it should be a parent should develop a habit in him that he should greet every elder of his house and every elder teacher or every elder person, whoever come to his house or whoever meet him, he should greet him first. You must greet people when you meet them by saying assalamu alaikum, and parents should develop, and teachers and parents should develop a habit of assalamu alaikum in them when they meet someone, not elder but younger them as well. Now look at the second picture. A child who has gone to an shop for buying an ice cream or something. Give me this. He is asking from a man, like, give me this. So they are advising us, you must say please give me this. Like they are asking, they are advising us, like you must say please when you want something. Like they are saying, like whenever you want something, whenever you are in need of something, you must ask them by saying please, can I, may I, can I, like, please is a very gentle word. It has a very good, it will be have a very good effect on your personality when you will use it. People will have it will leave a good impression on others. Are you getting me? Now look at the third picture. When a person gives you something, like when a person gives you something, say thank you. Whenever a shopkeeper or a whenever you someone relative of you come to your home and they give you something, then you must say thank you for that. This will also leaves a very good impression on them of yours. Are you getting me? Now look at the last picture. I'm sorry. Like two children you can see in the picture, and I think one has hurt the other one, and now he is saying sorry to him. No, sorry doesn't fulfill anything, but it leaves a very soft effect on the heart. And a person, when you hurt, like when you hurt someone, or when you whatever you if you did something wrong to them, you must say sorry. It leaves a very good effect on that person, a very good impact of you on them. When you hurt someone by mistake, say I'm sorry. Whatever you do, whenever anything wrong has been done, you should be you have the courage to say sorry to them. Are you getting me? What you have learned today, you must adopt a habit of saying assalamu alaikum, of saying please, of saying thank you when someone gives you something, and say you must apologize them. You must say sorry whenever you do something wrong or unethical. Are you getting me? Okay, I think today's lecture is clear to you, and we will in next lecture we will do the exercise of this chapter in your workbook. Okay, thank you.